Welcome back, everybody. It is supper time. I'm getting some potatoes peeled up for mashed potato. Well, I was gonna do mashed potatoes, but now I think we've decided we're gonna just do some like boiled potatoes with almost like a potato salad, just not all the ingredients of potato salad. Just maybe some butter, salt, pepper, green onions, maybe a little mayonnaise or sour cream or something. Almost potato salad. So we're having that. I already have the green bean casserole in the oven. I've showed y'all, it's pretty much the green bean casserole that's on the Campbell's can of cream of mushroom soup? Or it's on the back of the French's French fried onions. That's what it's on the back of. So I already have that in the oven, and we're just gonna have rolls with it because we have rolls left over from the other night, and cube steaks with gravy. I've already got my water boiling for the potatoes, so as soon as I get these peeled and chopped up, we'll get those boiling, then we'll start the cube steaks. I'm watching Jonah and Cece through the window. Tyler's out there with them. They're babysitting the little chicks, letting them be out for a little while. They still want to try to pick them up and hold them, but they're getting older now, and so they don't, you know, want to be picked up and held as much, and they're running around chasing them. Oh, she got one! I'm surprised they're not playing in the pool this evening. I told them if they wanted to, they better do it today because I think we're supposed to get some rain the next couple of days. All right, we've almost got these potatoes ready. Ready to start the cube steaks. I have 3 eggs in here. We're just going to beat these a little bit, and then I'm going to put in some milk. You can also put buttermilk, but I think I'm just going to put regular milk this time. I don't really measure it, probably just about 3/4 of a cup to a cup. I have 9 cube steaks, so this should be enough of the milk and egg mixture for that. I'm probably going to have to get more flour out, but that should be enough for the eggs and milk. So for the flour, I just put in some salt and pepper. You can put in any other kind of seasoning that you want to put in though. I'm gonna go ahead and get these opened up. And the trick to keeping the breading on the cube steaks is you wanna dip the cube steak in the flour mixture first. Just go ahead and get it coated really good with the flour on both sides, then dip it into the egg and milk mixture, and then back into the flour mixture. You could even do double dips if you wanted to and dip it again into the milk and egg mixture, then the flour mixture again, but I think this is pretty good here. We're gonna go with this. I used to have the hardest time making the breading stay on cube steaks. It would always come off, but when I started doing it this way, where we do flour first, then the egg and milk, and then flour again, it stays on pretty good. And you do have to, you know, you almost have to go by feeling with the heat, like how hot you keep your oil. The first ones that you put in, you want it to be pretty hot. Like right now I have it a little over medium. But as these start cooking, I'll turn it down. And by the time I get to the last two or the last cube steak, I'll probably have it almost on simmer, because as the oil gets hot and it starts, you know, cooking everything, you can turn it down lower and it'll cook it just fine. And I usually cook them for about 3 minutes on each side the first time that I flip. And then like I'll do 3 minutes, flip 3 minutes. Then when I flip again, I may only leave it on that side for 1 to 2 minutes. And then flip again 1 to 2, and then check. They're usually done then. So some of this cooking, you just gotta go by feeling. You just gotta feel it. All right, so we've got these two started. I'm just gonna wash up some dishes while I wait until time to flip them. Everybody. cube steaks are done. So I took a little bit of the liquid that was left in that pan and put it in here, but I cooked so many cube steaks that my oil it wasn't really gonna have a really good flavor because I just, you know, bits and pieces that fall off start getting burned in there and it's just not gonna taste that great. If you only do a couple of cube steaks, totally use what's left in that pan and just make your gravy. Since I make so many, I'm bringing out the bacon gold to use to make my gravy. So I have a little bacon grease that I had in the refrigerator. I just put that in here with some flour, salt and pepper, and now we just add milk until we get it where we like it. And we'll be ready to eat. Time for the evening exercise. We walk for 2 minutes, run for one for 30 minutes. This is the thinking spot over here. If you ever need somewhere to just sit and think, this is the place right here, the thinking spot. Let's brush hair, then we'll brush teeth.
Cheese.
That's right, we say cheese when we brush our teeth. Now say, ah. Good job.
My boy's in bed.
Yup, Manny's ready for bed.
I can't go to bed.
You can't?
Yeah, I'm ready to wake up.
There's nobody quite like Bubblegum Bear. He's bubblegum pink, and he doesn't care.
Can I read it?
Yeah, Manny can read it. Here, say this one. If it's cloudy and dull,
playground.
Yeah, sliding on the playground. He'll put on his boots to play outside, and all his friends follow to the big swirly slide. Bubblegum Bear never has any doubt that after the rain, the sun will come out.